No, it's there. It's 2-2-2. Oh, it does work.
Wait, check on this side.
No, you come down and go on this side. There we go. Now we're talking.
It's hard to speak on behalf of others when it comes to their projects, but we have marine biology, we have someone who does ecology, goes to Costa Rica, eye disease,
viruses, phage
as well, medicinal chemistry, natural product synthesis. So we have a pretty wide range of topics that are offered. Altogether, I think we get about almost 100 students per summer.
I think of summer research as a chance for our students to learn about science by actually doing science. They get to work more in depth for 10 weeks with a faculty mentor on a project where we don't know the answer. So the students are discovering new knowledge. It's also just a great time to know each other as people on a more personal level. You know, they get that in their classes. They get it a lot more in this setting.
Alex and I tried to do the math one time.
By us getting to know them, we can ask deeper questions. That is part of the education of shaping the whole students, not just in their skill set, but also in their lives in general. Many of them struggle with, like, what do I want to do? What if I want to be a doctor? Now what?
So I went to grad school for
that one-on-one relationship we can have over the summer that's much more casual and much more open, allows that conversation to happen because we'll kind of live together for 10 weeks. And I think that's the beauty of it. They're developing critical thinking skills. It's solving a problem and getting perspective about it by thinking through the problems. And that is, I think, what we try to accomplish over 10 weeks.
Research exposes students to things they wouldn't have considered. You know, we have students who come in really maybe not at all confident they should even be a chem major, and then they do research and they're like, oh, I can do this, you know, and they come out of their shell, and that's really, really exciting to see. I think a significant amount of it is appreciating their learning, appreciating the process of science and sort of how it works.
We have to be careful to not load bubbles, and so this process sometimes can be a little meticulous.
We try to do as much community building things that really allows them to be involved and establish relationships. It's good for them to see what each other is doing. Otherwise, it's very siloed.
It could be this or this, and so we like start looking at that, and then it's just like
when we present, they wrestle through issues together. And I think that's a good thing to see. Here's how people think about big problems and how it's not just a one discipline issue. It's a multi-discipline issue. You know, we don't solve one problem by just having one chemist work at something. It's typically everybody, computer scientists and biologists and chemists, and everybody's coming together for that big problem. And I think the more they get exposed to that, the better. It's again, exposure to trying something that they didn't know existed, or they didn't know about it as much until they did it. And now they have a chance to say, all right, do I want to pursue this or want to do something different? Eventually, we hope they become independent enough to start up making their own conclusions or come up with their own ideas or their own experiments.
What we want is in the liquid or the supernatant.
There's good evidence local employers see the value of the experience because we have a great track record for students who leave Point Loma and want to directly go into industry get snapped up, I think, largely because of this experience. You know, because whatever they do in the future, they're going to need to be consumers of science and to understand data, and they're going to need to deal with messy data and analyze and draw conclusions. And I think that's one of the perks of being at a place like Point Loma where you get that kind of broad exposure.
It should be fairly straightforward. I just hope it's going to work. And if it doesn't, we'll find other ways.
The research informs our teaching in many ways. It gives us a break. I get to be excited about something different. And we need the difference, because what we do discovery, we can bring it back in the classroom and say, oh, here's what I'm working on, here's what I discovered. It gives me like energy to come back in the fall and say, yes, that was a fun summer, let's do it again. So.
Yeah! You guys look great. Nice. Good job! Yeah.